Hello YouTube, it's Mark here. Going to record a video this evening, short video I guess, looking at Ecclesiastes chapter 4. We're going to read verses 8 to 12, and just some things I wanted to share with you this evening. Again, scripture to get you thinking about your walk, about the way that you are as a Christian, and about the way things are, just generally. And it's pretty thought-provoking actually. It's certainly got me thinking. So Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 8 to 12. There is one alone, and there is not a second. Yea, he hath neither child nor brother, yet there is no end of all his labour. Neither is his eye satisfied with riches. Neither saith he, for whom do I labour, and bereave my soul of good? This is also vanity, yea, it is sore travail. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labour. But if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him that is alone when he falleth, for he hath not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat. But how can one be warm alone? And if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him, and a threefold cord is not quickly broken. Amen. Great scripture. You've probably heard the very end of verse 12 a number of times in marriage ceremonies and all the rest of it. But the point that I wanted to raise from the get-go here is that, a Christian who is alone is in quite a bit of danger, so to speak, at a great risk, if you know what I mean. And some of them even actually seek out to be alone, you know, to put themselves in a cave somewhere to just disappear off the scene or whatever it might be, for one reason or another. On the other side of that, you've got Christians that are desperate for fellowship, desperate for someone to help lift them up, and they can't find anybody. You know, there's people that are just not around them for miles and miles and miles, and so on, even in the same continent, it feels like. And they just don't have people that care for them, that a like-minded man that will care for them. And it's a very, very common theme, especially with the few Christians that I speak to. And something more on that, I guess. If we go to Philippians chapter 2, and let's read verses 19 to 21. But I trust in the Lord Jesus to send Timotheus shortly unto you, that I also may be of good comfort when I know your state. For I have no man like-minded who will naturally care for your state, for all seek their own, and not the things which are Jesus Christ. And this is the issue, you know, that I wanted to make, I suppose, with this video about Christian loneliness, I suppose. You know, you have some that just simply isolate themselves, and others that are desperate for fellowship. But worse than that, you know, so many people just don't even care about other Christians. And you see this played out on YouTube to real grievous sort of extremes. The lack of care, you know, having any man like-minded who would naturally care, is, you just won't find it on YouTube. You pretty much won't find it anywhere. There's maybe one or two or something. And when you consider who's on there and how many Christians are professing Christians are spending their time on YouTube, and nobody cares about anybody. No one's trying to comfort anyone. No one's trying to really lift anyone up. And there are so many people alone and so many people that need help. It's just, it is so grievous. It's so painful, to be honest with you. Let's have a look at some more scripture, because that's the way that we deal with everything that we look at, see, observe, and experience. And you run everything through scripture, and all scripture, not just pieces of scripture. So Luke chapter 10, I want to read verses 30 to 37. Some great, great scripture. And Jesus answering said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and fell among thieves, which stripped him of his raiment, and wounded him, and departed, leaving him half dead. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. And likewise a Levite, when he was at the place, came and looked on him, and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him, and went to him, and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him on his own beast, and brought him to an inn, and took care of him. And on the morrow, when he departed, he took out 2 pence, and gave them to the host, and said unto him, Take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee. Which now of these 3, thinkest thou, was neighbour unto him that fell among the thieves? And he said, He that showed mercy on him. Then said Jesus unto him, Go, and do thou likewise. How about that for scripture, brethren? How about that to just get you thinking? You know, when was the last time you were helped, supported, or encouraged by someone? When was the last time you were the one to do that? You know, Jesus himself says here, go and do thou likewise. And I'm going to listen to the words of Jesus, not the words of men, and certainly not the words of men here on YouTube that have got nothing better to do than fight and bicker and call each other names and cast each other out of the church. We're called to show mercy. We're called to care for one another. And too often we hear of a man who is struggling, who has fallen, who is discouraged, and yet we just pass on by the other side, right? Just like the priest or the Levite. They even tell us, in some cases, that they have fallen. You know, I've corresponded with some saints, it's not many, it's just a few here and there, that say that they're struggling, that they're suffering, that they're in hardship and tribulation, and it just seems to fall on deaf ears. I've heard of Christians that have been, you know, emailing some of the other more prominent people on YouTube, and they just get no reply. You know, these channels or whatever have become so big that they can't even take care of the basics. And the basics are loving and caring for one another, looking after one another. And it just seems to have stopped, frankly. It's just too much effort, it seems, to actually stop. As it says here in Luke chapter 10, in verse 33, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him. It's just wholesale missing now. When you read the rest of what he does, it's so humbling. And, you know, it's something that I want to be like, something that I want to be more like. But yet, you know, YouTube especially, it's just full of priests and Levites, you know. And to actually stop and have compassion, to be walking down this road, to see a brother that's fallen, who's struggling, who's having difficulty, to actually, you know, stop and see this person and have compassion, it's just missing. Most people just go, you know, I don't want to deal with that. It's too much of a distraction. It's too much of an effort. It's too much of a burden. I can't deal with that right now. I have to do this, that, and this. And somewhere along the way, we've forgotten what it means to be a Christian. Everything else takes priority. I have to do this. I have to do that. And yet we forget this brother or sister that's struggling. It's something that I find very difficult to understand at times. And, you know, we prefer to walk alone, you know, in our own little sphere, really. You know, our lives, our work, our family, our homes, our health, our money. And, you know, we might even say in passing, you know, if we correspond with people or if we hear something on YouTube about a prayer request or something, we might say, oh, yeah, we'll pray for you. But you never do. You know, you say it, it's kind of like a box-ticking exercise. You know, oh, brother, I'll pray for you, but you don't. You don't spend time praying for them. And prayer should be a regular part of your life. And when you hear about brothers and sisters that are struggling and suffering, you should be getting to know them. You know, YouTube is such a cold, clinical environment, and nobody takes the time to get to know anyone. And that's why I've disabled comments a long time ago now, or a while ago now, I guess. And I like to conduct fellowship over email or Skype sometimes, and I like to get to know the person, and I like to understand what they deal with. And when I hear about their sufferings and sorrows and hardships, it grieves me, and it should grieve me. Instead of me just going, oh well, you know, I'm sure you'll be all right, and oh, I'll pray for you, but I never do, it grieves me. And I spend time in prayer for those brothers and sisters. So it's an attitude and a behavior that's virtually missing from the teachers in YouTube. And I personally don't understand it. You know, I really don't. And, you know, have you ever felt like that? I don't know if you've ever, if you do correspond with Christians, but have you got to know them? Have you been speaking to them and learning about their life? And when they are suffering, doesn't it not grieve you? And I just find it amazing, the people that say that they're Christians, especially the teachers here, and there's not a drop of grief in them. There's no compassion, there's no mercy, there's no sorrow for their brethren. I'm too busy fighting most of the time, you know. And it should bother you, brethren, and hugely so. It should weigh on your mind, it should grieve you, it should bother you. If someone says, I'm struggling with something, and there's so much piety and religiousness about people saying, oh, you know, I pray for you. But to really be, you know, in tears, or, you know, in just real kind of heartfelt prayer, that's something else, you know. And again, like a lot of things with the Christian life, you can't fake it. You know, we're not talking about perfect Christian walk, but we're talking about how you ought to be feeling about your brethren, the body, they're part of you. And again, it's another reason I have a major problem with a lot of these so-called teachers on YouTube and the way that they behave to Christians. But as I've said before, it's easy to justify that, right? If you cast them out of the church, then you can talk to people like dirt. You know, it's tragic, really. Let's take a look at some more scripture and then we'll finish here. Galatians chapter 6. Some of my favourite scripture in the Bible. Verses 1 to 3. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such an one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfil the law of Christ. For if a man think himself to be something, when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself. Really great scripture. Verse 2, the key one here. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfil the law of Christ. And I think the point that I wanted to make with this video, fairly short video, is I think sometimes we've forgotten what it means to be a Christian. You know, we sit here and make videos, we sit here and watch videos. You know, YouTube is just all about consumption, it's all about content, and nobody's, or very few people, are actually talking about what it means to be a Christian and what really matters. And this is the channel that I have here, very small channel, you know, not popular, not well known, and so on and so forth. But the few people that do watch, you know, I genuinely try to encourage all of you, and I point the finger always at myself, to be better Christians, to be better than what we are, and especially what we've become. And the last few years on YouTube have just been absolutely horrendous. If you spent any degree of time on YouTube among the King James Bible believing sort of teachers, if you want to call them that, you'll know that these kind of things are just so lacking, it's unreal, you know. And the Christian walk, the thing is, it's hard. It's really hard. If anybody says it's easy and it's full of blessings, well, there's problems with that. The Christian walk is really hard and really trying. But we ought not to be doing that alone and unsupported and unhelped and unloved and uncared for. And yet so many of us are walking down this road and, you know, falling among thieves, and there's no one to help pick us up or them up, or, you know, whoever we're talking about. But we're told to be together. We're told to be fellowshipping with one another, and caring about one another, and loving one another, and it just isn't there. Like I said, you know, a few minutes back, there's just Levites and priests everywhere. It's like, oh, you know, that guy's fallen, and that's it. They just walk on by, pass on by the other side. But no one actually stops and sees someone and has compassion on them, and it's just a very, very sad state of affairs. You know, we don't even think about one another sometimes. It's just we're all caught up in our own lives and, you know, work this and this part of our life and that thing we have to take care of, and we just forget the people that matter the most to us, which are our brothers and sisters in the Lord, you know. And that's how I kind of want to end the video. It's something that's just really bothering me a lot lately, and it's been something that I've been teaching and preaching about for a while now. This total lack of love in the body, this total lack of compassion and mercy, and you know, just a near void of grace toward one another. It's something I find very difficult to deal with, brethren, I have to be honest. And I just, my exhortation in this video is consider the scriptures. It tells us how to behave and how we ought to act. And the command that we've been left with by the Lord Jesus Christ is to love one another. And yet it's virtually entirely missing. So please do consider the scriptures. If you do know someone that is struggling and suffering and having trouble, talk to them. You know, help them in some way, any way. You know, don't let them walk alone, okay? Because it's a cold walk. If there's two of you, it's warm, there's heat. You know, it's a cold walk when you're on your own. And I encourage those that have set out to try and walk by themselves because they've been let down time and time again, you know, reach out to someone that's going to help you and stick together, you know? Work together, labour together. And, you know, if you are looking for someone, you will find them. There are Christians out there that are just as desperate for fellowship as you are. And I personally have been so thankful for the fellowship that I have. It's not many people, it's just a few people here and there. And I'm grateful for the emails and those kind of things. But, you know, it's been real discouraging the last year or so. Real discouraging for me personally to just see how people treat one another. And when you know that somebody is suffering and struggling, how they're just kind of left alone, really, and nobody's there to help them. And, you know, it's hard to think about, it's hard to record, it's hard to talk about. So please do look at the scriptures. And, you know, again, if you know someone that needs help, then help them. You know, if you're talking to somebody, if you're emailing someone, perhaps you correspond with somebody or something, find out about them, you know, express an interest in them, ask them questions about, you know, what they're dealing with, offer to help them, pray for them, and genuinely pray for them. Don't just tick a box and say, well, you know, I did pray about your thing that you requested. You know, heartfelt prayer to the Lord, pleading, petitioning him to help this brother or sister that's struggling or has an issue or whatever it is. It's revolutionary to be like that, but it seems to be something that's, you know, entirely missing nowadays. Very, very sad, really. So, short video. Thank you for watching. God bless and Godspeed. Thank you.